الحمد لله، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على آل إبراهيم. وبعد، I was thinking of what it means when Allah says about Yunus عليه الصلاة والسلام فلولا أن كان من المسبحين للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون. Had Yunus been not a مسبح, he would have been living or staying in the belly of the whale until the day of يوم القيامة. I want to let you know what that means in Yusuf's story. You know, in Yunus's story, Yunus عليه الصلاة والسلام, as a prophet, a messenger, he used to live in north of Iraq today, and once he was very angry with people there. It is not Yunus the only person who could feel anger. Even Allah says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Hud, فلعلك تارك بعض ما يوحى إليك وضائق به صدرك أن يقولوا لولا أنزل عليه كنز لولا أنزل عليه كنز أو جاء معه ملك. You see, Allah said to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, maybe sometimes you feel this kind of annoyance that your heart is become so tight and as if you want to leave getting involved in carrying out the message because of what they say, the mushriks say, of challenges or of any rebuke or insult. So then Yunus had some sort of disagreement with his people that he left them and ran away. وَذَنُّونِي يُونُسْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا. He left his people with anger. And he thought that فَظَنَّ أَلَّا نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. He thought that he won't have a harder time. أن نقدر عليه doesn't mean we can or cannot. No, we tighten, we make him have a rough and a tight and a harder life or circumstances. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him in the tight punishment. Then listen. The Quran says, فلولا أن كان من المسبحين. What do you think? It means he used to have a مسبحة. I used to see many brothers have a مسبحة and they were using it. You know مسبحة. Does that mean that Yunus had a مسبحة with him and he started saying, سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله day and night? Do you think that way? Maybe this is the only idea many could have. No. Like التسبيح means whenever you remember Allah. For example, when a woman or a man calls calls me saying, I want to buy a house. Is it halal to buy the house on mortgage or not? What is this person doing? The question is tasbih. He wants to please Allah. He doesn't want to make Allah angry with him. So, when you stop before doing anything, unless you get the information if this is halal or not, this is tasbih. When you, for example, your friend says to you, let us go to beach. Your friend wants to take you to beach. And you have in mind, why do I go to beach for? Maybe I'm likely, if I go to beach, I see some women or whatsoever who are not dressed properly. It doesn't fit my situation. When you say, I don't go because of such a, this is tasbih. This is what? Tasbih. If you want to eat, and you try to make sure that this food has nothing haram, if you do that, that is tasbih. When you want to get married, a Muslim says, I want to get married. I look for the knowledge of my woman of deen. Does she have good knowledge of deen? Is she committed to deen? Does she make salah regularly? This is tasbih. Like, I went to buy some stuff from a place in Iraq in 1967, 68, I still remember. I wanted to buy some stuff. You know, a person who has the store said to me, son, are you in a hurry to buy this stuff? I said, no. He said to me, wait until April. I was in February at his store. He said to me, wait until April because you will have the good stuff for you. This is tasbih. What he did is tasbih. Because he doesn't think about making profit from me as much as he thought, what is good advice for me to give me his advice as a Muslim. This is tasbih. Here I am coming to some funny language. When you put your shoes on the rack, wallahi it is tasbih. Wallahi it is tasbih. When you don't put any dirt, a napkin or an empty bottle or an empty glass anywhere in the masjid, if you stop doing that for Allah, it is tasbih. When you hear your friend is discussing something and he wants to start backbiting, stop. You say to your friend, stop. I cannot hear any backbite. This is tasbih. Anything you do to please Allah is tasbih. And you can count now after me. So then, we go back to the Prophet and Messenger Yunus alayhi salatu wassalam. What happened? After after he was in the belly of the whale, he recognized that he did something sinful. He made Allah angry with him. What should he do? He should make his istighfar and feel his grief. So he felt his mistake and reviewed what he did. He should have been patient with people, not to be upset because anyone offended him. You cannot, as a Muslim, feel offended by anybody, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us that we should be patient, and we know that the الصابرين وبشر الصابرين. Allah said, give the best news to those who are patient. الصابرين. And إن الله مع الصابرين. Allah is in the company of those who are صابرين. Then Yunus reviewed everything of that, and his life started to be a life of what? Of al-musabbihin. فَلَوْلَا أَنْ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. It means he is living in a way Allah in his mind, in his heart, and everything he thinks about is Allah. And that is the peak of at-tawheed. Because at-tasbih originally is to keep on the track that leads you from dunya to the Jannah. That is another topic. Someday I explain three examples I did before I explain the meaning of tasbih. So here, in brief, I say Yunus now becomes one of al-musabbihin. It doesn't mean exclusively to say subhanallah, but it means he is thinking of in everything, in every sort of thought, how would I please Allah? For example, I was sitting at a table. We had a fundraiser years ago. And I am sitting with a group of brothers on a table. When I look, somebody was seated by me. I was not spying over him, but accidentally I saw him write a check for the masjid that had, it is not Darul Hijra, some other masjid. He writing $20,000. He is an MD doctor. I see him, he writes the check $20,000. What impression I would get? Wallahi, since then, this brother, I see him every now and then when I go to New Jersey. I don't see him the same image I used to see him before. I see him so great, so big. Very big image in my mind, in my eyes. Because when somebody gives 20,000 or somebody gives more than that, anyhow, the man who gives sadaqah, a sadaqah is tasbih. Here in this community, in this community, I know people who Allah gave them money, but the way you say Allah gave them money, the way you say they are not careful about money when it goes for Allah. I know many Muslims, maybe you don't know them, I know them. They don't care about thousands or hundreds of thousands or million or more than a million to be given for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is tasbih. And the tasbih is of different levels. So whatever you practice of remembrance of Allah and you do anything to please Allah, and you abstain from doing anything that displeases Allah, this is the peak of tasbih. Then Yunus made a mistake in his life, in dunya life, that he got angry with people in a wrong way. To correct that, he started building up his plans and this strategy to do everything to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the time he was in the belly of the whale, he doesn't have in mind and heart, in utterance, in any action, other than how I can please Allah. And he was in touch with Allah for the whole time, perpetually, without any interruption. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. And again, I want you to read, فَلَوْلَا أَنْ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. So inshallah, when you leave the salah, remember what I say to you. Whatever you do of good to please Allah, then that is of tasbih. I'm not saying that to you because I am smart enough to put it in that frame. Like when I say to you, don't leave the masjid without putting something in the hand of Allah. I am not making a commercial. I feel that when you give sadaqah, as-sadaqah to Burhan, it is the evidence that you are, oh, let me put it today in this language, you put it in the hand of Allah, you are a mutasaddiq and you are a musabbih. So then, don't forget to make your tasbih today as you are leaving the masjid, and put the sadaqah that matches with what you acquired of knowledge today. فَلَوْلَا أَنْ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. أَخِمْ الصَّلَاةِ.